to No Man's Sky. Very excited to be back in this game. Not so excited to be on this planet because it's pretty horrible here. So we're actually gonna take off and get the heck out of here. Because there's like no atmosphere whatsoever. Now what's the closest planet? Is that the closest one, I guess? Okay, wrong button. That's the right button. I think that's the closest one. Should go back into space. Scan that planet. Lots of things on our... So there's lots of things on this planet over here. This planet looks quite nice though, doesn't it? It looks a bit blue. Now, I do need some more iron, actually, while we're here. So I might just pick some up by farming these asteroids. I think the game does look a lot better, by the way. It runs a lot better. Yeah, I like it. I didn't think I'd be jumping back in and playing through No Man's Sky again. I wanted to. I just didn't really think that like a new update would really grab me. But okay, what's it say about this? Flourishing planet. Oh, I like the sound of that. Flourishing right up my street. Forsaken. No thanks. Okay. Okay, how much iron we got? Oh, look at that. Oh, we are sorted. Okay. There we go. Star bulbs, aluminium, iridium, and iridium. I need some iridium, actually, I think it's iridium we need for some upgrades. I want to get a little bit of upgrade going before we head off to the other planet. I have no idea what is involved. I'm doing the Atlas path. I never did it when I played the game originally. I skipped it because I just kind of wanted to explore and stuff like that. I don't think I was missing a huge amount. But I'm excited to kind of do it now because I know they've added a lot more to it. So yeah, we'll see. But so far so good. Flourishing planet, can't wait. It looks nice, it looks like it's got oceans, it looks like it's got greenery. I hope it's a planet I'm going to fall in love with. Because that last one, still, you can't have a nice planet without having the bad planets compared to it too, right? Interesting as well. Okay. Oh yeah, this one looks pretty green. I like one with water as well. I like the like underwater creatures and things like that that you have. Okay. Oh, this looks nice. This looks like the sort of place I could get a holiday home in. Let's see if we've got somewhere where. See if we've got a base or something that we can land in. Doesn't actually look like anything nearby. We've got these big kind of pillars of red. Let's go land down here by the beach or something. Not many trees, is there? I guess there's a few up there. Not a bad thing, necessarily. I love the fact that you can fly lower, that is such a little thing, but it makes a huge difference. Well, would you look at this place. Wet weather, low security sentinels, bountiful flora, but few fauna, okay. Hey buddy, how's it going? How's it going, buddy? We've got a nice little cave down. Quite exciting. Oh god, I fell down the cave. There's a little box over here. That's a different one as well, I haven't seen, isn't it? If you discover all the inventory full, damn it. Back to the ship. If you discover all the gets rid of that. What do we want to do? We want to install some a bolt caster, and we want to install a mining speed. There we go. As much as we can do on there. Exosuit wise, probably want to install this stamina enhancer, so we need iron for that. Okay, let's get some iron. Let's go into night time. Minus 36 degrees, that's quite cold actually. Yeah, oh shit. I apologise, that scared the living crap out of me there. I did not see that. Okay. Oh, we now know the Viking word for Viking. Good to know. Good to know. Oh, there's something over there. Babala. Babala. What do I need iron, don't I? These rocks be iron, won't they? Yeah. Oh, you can die as well. Take that, you son of a gun. What's this? Infantry form. Typical. What's that? Oh, some ships. Oh, the Sentinel as well, so kind of keeping an eye on things. Now, I said they were fairly low security, so I'm not too worried about them. It's probably worth keeping an eye on. Probably want this plutonium. You have to be careful when your inventory's full, because if it's full and you don't realise it, it just kind of wastes the stuff have, so do have to be pretty careful. At least my spaceship is fixed now though. Right, we wanted a stamina enhancer, but we need to chuck some stuff onto our install technology. Ah, we need some more iron. Okay. I thought I had enough. My bad. There's lots of plutonium here, that's good. As I said before, plutonium is a very, very useful thing. That's just thallium, to be fair. However you want to pronounce it. How much iron have we got? We got enough. We got enough of the irons. There's my ship. There it is. Try and move everything we can. Okay, we could move that. Good. That's what we want. There we go. Now we got like extra run distance, I guess. Sure, it's going to be useful for something. The question is now, what do we need? Actually, we probably just need to try and find something which we can farm for some credits. Maybe explore a little bit as well while we're around here. What's this thing? Is it friendly? No, it's not. Run. Get away. Get away. Get away. That's not friendly. Let's get Noshim and take off before that sentinel gets a bit fresh with us. Okay, now there was a little green question mark somewhere around here. There it goes down there. Let's see what that is. Some supplies which I don't think I want right now. It's probably plutonium, and I don't think I want that. Wrong button. Okay. I didn't realise how high I actually went there. You can go in the water and stuff like that as well. There is animals in the water. Usually there's something that's going to kill you in the water. So I tend to avoid it as much as possible. Okay, they're off planet, aren't they? Yeah, that's fine. That's not a problem. We'll have a little look here and then we'll head towards that beacon, I think. Oh my god, I love the fact that you can fly really low. That's so cool. You just couldn't do that in the first one. It would just wouldn't let you, basically. Trees for me on this planet to be one of my personal favourites. Like a nice planet with a lot of trees and less rocks, I guess. Not exactly picking up like a lot of stuff, are we, on the your scanners? One. Let's go here. Let's see what this is. If I do find a planet that I really like, I probably will try and like discover all the animals on there and all the fauna and stuff like that. Can make good money off doing that as well. It's an option. More likely to make money though by mining and selling materials. This thing is still over this way. Because I did get to a point in my other game where I had like a really good like multi-tool. I had like a really good ship, everything. And I deleted it. Started all over again. Crazy, right? There's something to be said for that though. I felt like it needed a fresh beginning. Wow, this thing's bloody miles away. So is there nothing closer? God. Okay, let's do the old trick, which is the higher you go, the quicker you can get to a place. Lost where this thing is. Oh, there's probably something there. That looks like the sort of place that would hide something. It certainly does, actually. It's like a backpack upgrade. What was that? Shit, there's a bleep. Oh, for God's sake. There's a bloody plant thing right under my ship. Way to introduce me to this place, game. I need to use this. How do I use this? Activate weapon. Oh, the fire mode's why. Got it. Because every time I come out of this thing, stuff. Doesn't actually seem a lot going on this planet. Los infantry's full. Okay. That iron. It's a shielding shard, okay. This thing should sell us a backpack upgrade, yeah. I should probably have gone to the space station. What's this planet got on it? So it's very exciting for me anyway to go through the planets and have a look at them and all that kind of stuff. It's one of the things I love. Knowing what there is going to be. I think I've got enough to, yeah. Wow, we could definitely do with some, that was the one we were just on, wasn't it, yeah. Let me scan this yet. Oh, frozen planet, frost crystal, emerald, copper, oh, emerald's good. That's something which we can make money off of. Get in pretty quick because I'm running out of fuel and there weren't any asteroids just now. Frozen planet. I do like an icy planet. Big fan of that. Can have a bit of a problem with your suit not having the right protection, but you know, you gotta take the rough with the smooth, as they say. Just how frozen is it? It looks pretty darn frozen. Range of planets, isn't there? In this system. This is Christmas planet. Freezing. Typical sense of the flipping heck of those things. Frost protection is pretty weak. life signs detected. Distress beacon. It's on another planet, okay. Thanks. Okay, next question, how the hell do I get out of here? Over there. That's platinum. Do I have in my exosuit plutonium? No. Okay, just use all those shielding shards. There we go. Anyway. Oh, it's only minus 38 during the day. Oh, that's nice. Might have just accidentally wiped out one of those little creatures. Accidentally. Okay, charge you. Charge you. Good stuff. See you later. See you later, Sentinel. Oh, there's some nice trees down here. Now, there's this ruin here. If I hit my busters, my thrusters, how long does it take to drive there? 22 minutes, let's go up. She gets there a little bit faster. Then we'll go and have a look at that signal. That distress signal, apparently. Is it distressed? I do not know. Some of the like words of the civilization or the race, sorry, that inhabits your particular system. But we'll see. We shall see this ruin holds in just a moment. It's interesting, isn't it? How the hell am I supposed to get up there? I don't think I can fly over that far. I've got to sink over there. Let's transfer some stuff, I guess. If I don't make it, I might die though. Yeah, well. Gotta live a little, haven't you? Gotta live a little. Okay. Yes. Civilization was once absorbed by this strange marker. The story of the Viking somehow spills out in the language of my own people. The noble travellers will be spared. Their journey through the cosmos shall not be thwarted, so it is decreed. The will of the Hook commands it. The Viking shall honour the judgment and the beliefs of the ancients. To help with language. Good. So they taught me some words, basically. To learn the words for ancients. And our standing with the Viking has increased. An accomplice rank 3. Okay. Just have a little look in this cave because this looks pretty spectacular actually. Stuff. Emerald. Ah, emerald. Yes, please. places. 144, fantastic. I was on the floor as well. Well, well, well. It should be able to give us a good start, actually. If we head to a space station, we can sell this. Usually for some good cash. Why is it saying exocraft mining laser required? Because I seem to be having no problems. That's fine. Still harvest some of this emerald. Off this, but it'll give us a little bit of a boost, which is always very useful. I may well do some mining and stuff off camera as well, so don't worry, we won't do it constantly. Okay, another 9 emeralds. Something at least. That seems to be worth quite a lot. How much is it saying the emerald's worth? Yeah, you make about 120,000 off that. Iridium shield shard. Let's get rid of that. Sod it. I'm gonna take one of these marrow bulbs. How much are they worth? Around here, wasn't it? There's another one around here as well. There we go. Another milestone accomplished. It's a dance party, everybody. Let's go. Okay, I do want this plutonium, guys. I don't have any plutonium currently. Have I got it on my ship? Exosuit. Oh yeah, I do kind of want this, so just stay out of my way and I won't blast you. Can't say fairer than that, can I? Okay. Well, ironically, that is what we can use our plutonium for. Isn't that good? Isn't that good? There's going to be a sentinel somewhere, isn't there? Oh yeah, he's got spies on me. Let's go. Let's get out of here. So I think so long as you're not mining anything when he scans you, then they leave you alone. Okay, let's go. Nice planet, but a bit cold for my liking. There's a gym base over there. It'd be rude not to just check that out quickly. Identified terminal not active, unlocking data logs for analysis. It looked like a wound on the world, crimson and ragged edged, like something that once lived but was then torn asunder. I should have stayed away. Had I the senses to taste the air of this planet, I imagine it would have reeked with some kind of alien fetal. But nothing could stall my curiosity. Was it dead? Where I touched it, the surface was moist and yielding. It seemed to have become motile then, crawling on a map of slow cilia, moving from me. I should have left it alone. I discovered something coded deep inside long dead traveler's data log. Something has been left that will aid me on my journey. Good. What is it? Nanite clusters, okay. I'm sure they're useful for something. Oh, fantastic. Some units. Inventory full. That thing will hurt us if we go near it. This goop's a little bit freaky, isn't it? We should probably just get the heck out of here. Hey, we did save it, didn't we? I hope so. Oh, it's quite beautiful. It's a question of how far away is the space station. 20 hours away. How far is that? 14 hours away. Let's go to the space station first. I know I've been kind of like putting off going to go see this Atlas thing. Okay, that's going to make me... Yeah, I was going to say it's not going to let me... Need to get past this planet first. Less than a minute to get to the space station, so we might as well go and have a look. I haven't seen if they've done anything different to space stations or not. I wouldn't have thought they'd done too much different to it, but you never know. You never know. I like the cockpit design of these ships. It's nice and open. See around everywhere. It's pretty good. domestic and space station. You should just have to like fly up to this blue globe here, and it just kind of sucks you in. So the way it is, no, that's not it. It's looking good. It's pretty awesome, actually. The music is like thumping, though. The bodies of everything is moving loud. Look at this ship. That looks quite cool, actually. In a kind of like a very square way, but I quite like it. Let's see how much he wants for it. Okay. How much he wants? 4 million. Okay. Yeah, I don't think I'm quite gonna have the but this music just kind of apologies about that. That's a nice ship as well. Actually, I don't know about that. That's got a very long nose. That's like the Big Bird of ships, isn't it? I quite like this one though. And the fact that it's really good anyway, I also like, but hey buddy. Interloper, replace Urg. Wow, he looks at me with fire in his eyes. Species is clearly aggressive. I doubt I'll welcome yet. Yet the life form bows in greeting, tradition, honor, perhaps dictator. I don't feel an immediate danger at about to turn and leave when the creature points towards my multiple. It barks a concern and makes a motion to suggest that I should hand over. Hand over. The warrior nods in satisfaction, offers me an improved replacement multi-tool. Sure. Oh yeah, I'll take that. Absolutely. Let me just, yes, accept. Okay, thank you very much, Liquidator. Harmony of Tashumb. I'll take it. Terrain Manipulator. I like the sound of that. I don't know what you're saying. The warrior is silent for a second before looking at me conspiratorially. He looks behind, checks with colleagues before powering down the Tsurugi system. Warrior pulls up the trade valve at his feet, which seems to be plied high with multi-tool upgrades, indicates the content of the inventory as a trade. Let's do this. No, I don't want to threaten to report him. I'll give him 1,000 units. Warrior sighs and slams the trade valve shut. Units are presumably traceable, but oh, right. Okay, well, I didn't have any stuff for you anyway. Oh, look at this guy. This is the Galactic Trade Terminal. Let's sell our some items from our inventory. We want to sell that for absolutely. Sell them. Sell that. How's this stuff? I don't have any of this. Oh, is that stuff I can buy, maybe? I don't know. Don't really want to sell anything else. And who are you, sir? Blueprint trader. Interloper, la 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 la. I don't know what you're saying yet. Warrior offers me blueprint for weapon upgrades in exchange for nanite clusters. Oh, okay. Glares at me as I approach, trying to groom into a smile, but failing at this, he seems unhappy. Yeah, I'll trade. How much do these cost? I thought you said I could trade for nanite clusters. Oh, here we go. Scatter Blaster Reload Sigma. Oh, these cost 460, 400, 200 nanite clusters. Okay, it was good to know that they are what they're used for, I guess, even though we only have 85. So they're practically useless right now. But we have got ourselves a new multi-tool. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is pretty darn... Whoa! Look at this bad boy. And two aliens. Oh, great. That's awesome. That's an awesome looking ship. How much you want for that, bad boy? Okay. Yeah. Hey. Interloper, blah blah blah. Okay. 7 million. Oh, okay. world for a face beam. Oh man, now I just want to go and mine all day long until I can afford that. Yeah. Okay. Slightly guided, I deleted my save now. Well. From humble beginnings. You know, from Acorns, oh hi. Mission listing agent. Oh. Lifeforge just spotted it. The exact meaning is unclear, but it's apparent there's no worth me here. Okay, I guess I have to be like a higher level or something.